Vacuum box testing is an effective leak testing technique used to inspect welding joints. This is a relatively fast test and one that can be conducted without interfering with other fabrication operations. The test uses a box fitted with rubber seals around its open bottom and a plexiglass top cover. The weld section to be inspected is coated with a soap-like solution and a light vacuum, usually under 69 kPa or 10 psi, is applied to the box. The formation of bubbles on the soaped weld indicates the location of a leak. Vacuum box testing can be used on lap welds, shell to annular welds, butt welds, pressure vessels, piping systems, among many others. Vacuum box testing is used in order to locate seam leaks in the welds of storage tanks. Vacuum box testing is great as it is capable of immediately locating any leaks. It can also detect the smallest leaks inside a given area. The vacuum box used shall be of approximately 150 mm wide by 750 mm long in size and contain a clear window in the side opposite the open bottom, which provide proper visibility to view the area under inspection. During testing, illumination shall be adequate for proper evaluation and interpretation of the test. The open bottom edge shall be equipped with a suitable gasket to form a seal against the test surface. Suitable connections, valves, lighting, and gauge shall be provided. The gauge shall have a range of 0 psi to 15 psi. The gauge shall register a partial vacuum of at least 2 psi below atmospheric pressure or the partial vacuum required by the referencing code section. A partial vacuum of 21 kPa to 35 kPa shall be used for the test. If required, a secondary partial vacuum test of 56 kPa to 70 kPa shall be performed for the detection of very small leaks. The required vacuum can be developed in the box by any convenient method. Example: air ejector, vacuum pump, or motor intake manifold. The bubble forming solution used for this inspection shall produce a film that does not break away from the area to be tested, and the bubbles formed shall not break rapidly due to air drying or low surface tension. The number of bubbles contained in the solution should be minimized to reduce the problem of discriminating between existing bubbles and those caused by leakage. Soaps or detergents designed specifically for cleaning shall not be used for the bubble forming solution. As per API 650, soap film solution and commercial leak detection solution, applicable to the conditions shall be used. The bubble forming solution shall be compatible with the temperature conditions of the test. As a standard technique, the temperature of the surface of the part to be examined shall not be below 5 degrees Celsius nor above 50 degrees Celsius throughout the examination. Local heating or cooling is permitted provided temperatures remain in the range of 40 Fahrenheit to 125 Fahrenheit during the examination. Where it is impractical to comply with the foregoing temperature limitations, other temperatures may be used provided that the film solution is proven to work at temperature outside these limits, either by testing or manufacturer's recommendations. The surface areas to be tested shall be free from oil, grease, paint or other contaminants that might mask a leak. If liquids are used to clean the component or if a hydrostatic or hydropneumatic test is performed before leak testing, the component shall be dry before leak testing. Application of solution. The bubble forming solution shall be applied to the surface to be tested by flowing, spraying, or brushing the solution over the examination area before placement of the vacuum box. Vacuum box placement. The vacuum box shall be placed over the solution-coated section of the test surface and the box evacuated to the required partial vacuum pressure or vacuum retention. The required partial vacuum or differential pressure shall be maintained for at least 10 seconds or the time required for the inspection. Lighting. The specific part, component, vessel, or section thereof, under immediate examination, shall be illuminated, if necessary with flashlight or other auxiliary lighting, to attain a minimum of 1076 lux for general examination. Overlap. The vacuum box test shall have at least 50 mm overlap of previously viewed surface on each application. Evaluation of the test. The presence of a through-thickness leak indicated by continuous formation or growth of a bubble or foam, produced by air passing through the thickness, is unacceptable. The presence of a large opening leak indicated by a quick bursting bubble or spitting response at the initial setting of the vacuum box is unacceptable. Leaks shall be repaired and retested. Advantages of vacuum box testing method. Provides an immediate indication of any leaks present produced directly on the tested surface. Easy to use. Large areas can be inspected rapidly and at low cost. Can detect small leaks within a given area. Requires only access to one side of the tested surface. The method is relatively clean, does not require comprehensive cleaning after the test. Disadvantages of vacuum box testing method. Can only detect leaks. Other welding defects including surface imperfections are not identified. Surface preparation before testing including cleaning, degreasing, rust and slag removal can be time consuming. The method should not be applied to painted objects. Size and orientation of any leaks will have to be analyzed with a secondary NDT method. For standard testing, surface temperature must be between 5 degrees Celsius and 50 degrees Celsius. Otherwise, a procedure effective at non-standard temperature range must be demonstrated.